Now, where do you go from here now and make the most of it? Do you, I mean, frankly, what all I'm thinking of is like maybe, oh, I was going to say like a Spectre Vega or something, but they got a Sven.
Spectre? Sven. That would have been really good too, actually. They don't have that much damage or gank potential, so why not just go all the way and try to farm up and fight in the mid game? It looks like Sven, as you said, is the pickup. Warcry, I don't see the effectiveness being too strong this game, as most of Vega's damage comes in the form of magic or pure. But it definitely helps. Like, Warcry is a spell right now that if you see it, cast it, heroes just don't seem to die in the duration.
Is there just some like weird interaction though? You got a clockwork on your team. He's jumping in, dropping cogs, and you're like, hey buddy, I can't really get in there to fight. You mind? And I feel like that's always just something that can kind of haunt you a bit when you commit to a melee core when you already also have a clockwork on your team.
I see what you're saying. But I think Sven, I think he plays with a blink dagger naturally. So it might be different.
I can't believe we're about to have a game where Slardar is just completely ignored. It's just something special. But
it's just the meta, man. You lose three games straight, basically, and then mm-hmm. and then you start doubting your pick. You have to change something, right? A lot of these teams, they start with the picks, and then it's the players.
I guess that makes sense. Yeah, it's worked for most. Vega, last grab here though, and their offlane grab. What's still left? Well, the Slardar. So we may not make it out the game without seeing it here. And Broodmother was also ignored.
Actually, I would never run Broodmother into Sven, I think.
Maybe that's why they got the Sven. They're like, oh god, we forgot about Brood. They might go for it. Oh, you gotta be kidding
me. Oh my goodness.
What you did there, and I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna show you how it's done.
Yep.
Come on, tell me that's not how it is. That is how it is.
You know, Vega, actually, now that you bring it up, Vega are the ones that started playing Ursa pretty frequently recently. I say frequently, but like they would just occasionally drop a game or two of it in like a 2 best of 3 series or something like that. Secret might have actually watched them play and try to do it themselves last game.
And Vega are like, oh, I remember that hero.
Yeah.
All right. Let me show you how it's done.
Page.
Oh, this is great. All right. We'll see how Pasha could do it. Pasha is definitely getting a lot of positive attention from a lot of viewers now. This guy's really becoming a very popular core player. And, you know, you can't ever hate on Vega. They're always that first team after a tournament. They're like, we're staying together.
We're not
changing a thing.
First to stay. Like,
we're out, but I assure you, we're still in it together. I admire that. You know, who doesn't like a team that actually stays a team?
I agree, man. They're so good. Like, if they lose, it's definitely due to, like, an unlucky streak. Like, these guys are very reminiscent of the old Power Rangers, except they're more consistent, and I would say they come in a better form as well. They not only they can just take off random games, but they'll just win the series, because they are that good. And, you know, let's see if they can execute this game to do it, because this time, I feel like the ball is in their hands.
I mean, who would have thunk? I didn't really get a chance to look over the odds at the start of the series, but if it could be a 2-0 by Vega, that would be pretty swell, and everyone would not really know where to rank anybody. I mean, we're seeing Na'Vi perform crazy good one day, and now Secret having a bit of a tough time, at least game one, against Vega. We'll see how it's going to go this go around now. Vega 5-manning through this bottom woods. You got to remember the last game, it was Secret who got the first blood advantage set up with that sleep skewer. This time, though, the sleep will not be set up. They are going to be equally spread out. Puppy even flirting a bit with danger here, but they are going to stay out of harm's way, most importantly. And let's see what kind of wards they're dropping here, Claire. They dropped the pub ward here, the easy one straight north that sometimes you might not just anticipate. And they will even plant a secondary one. Oh no, that was the secret pub ward. Okay, I see now. They see that ward. That one's going to get countered right away.
Yep.
And Vega will secure the bottom room. All right.
Level 1 rolls commence.
Yeah, right? Oh man, that would be something special. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to see very many of those too often, especially at LAN, or LAN rather, so.
LA.
Might better get it at the online group stage while you can. Not happening here. And they're going to go aggro. An aggro setup from Vega into the aggro setup, or the tri-lane at least, a secret. Oh, Clairvoyance, tell me, how is this going to be going?
Well, Vega definitely have the aggression option, not only because they're in this lane, but they have a lot more tools to fight. Mm-hmm. Secret, again, playing reactionary in this lane for the time being and just letting their solos or hoping their solos would do better with the Clockwork as well as the Shadow Fiend. Mid's gonna be somewhat difficult, I think, and no one's already putting in a lot of pressure on Weeha.
Oh, they're putting it for Puppy. Bottom lane, they're gonna get the sleep. Pasha runs in. You're gonna get hit up with the dog, and they got the last hit in there. Seema's gonna be able to pick up that one, and he is the Slayer of First Blood. Oh, we got the Slayers going against each other, Clairvoyance. Seema the Slayer, Misery the Slayer. Nice.
Yeah, we'll see who's the real Slayer, the one to get slain. But I think that right there is a very classic demonstration of why Secret have to play reactive. They needed Pilot to die there, but he was busy pulling, trying to get a lane, better lane set up a minute down the road. But it's just so easy for Vega. So one sleep, chilling touch on three heroes, and each right click becomes double damaged.
Yep. And that was just to start with like level one. Now you got a level two Ursa, so now you're gonna get the swipes coming in, and this is rough. Rough for Secret, and specifically gonna be a little rough here for EE to try to sneak in and get farm. Even stuff like that. When the puppy's forced to pull out the heal, it's gonna kinda mess the lane a bit and possibly mess with the last hits of EE. This is just gonna have to be the lane that I keep my camera close to, unfortunately, but I do want to check out mid lane a bit. We at 5-2 CS and no one up and ahead, 9-3. Very nice.
Yep, somewhat expected, I would say, between Alina versus SF matchup, but he missed the last couple of slaves, so that really alleviates the potential pressure coming out of him. No, Weeha in the meantime, pardon me, bottom lane.
Yep, they get the quick grab on your AA. Pi in trouble now. Pincer between the trees, and he will be going down. Pasha's going to pick up the last hit on that one, and they are going to continue to tussle here. Way outside the lane, they are just looking to throw punches, and it looks like, oh! Swung, but not get it. Salve, and he's out. Pash is fine. He's going to be able to make it away from trouble. Look at Seema, though. He's been making a move on Puppy. Now sleep it. Envy's going to be the one in trouble. Nice D-sleep from Puppy, but that just makes an easy setup and an easy kill. Seema's actually going to get the last tick on that one, but this aggro setup is going very, very nicely for Vega, and Vega showing where Ursa really thrives and what particular lane setup.
Yeah, just wants to fight. Definitely not a hero that wants to sit back and farm and definitely play aggressive with the, you know, that Earth Shock. It has so much good early value coming out of it. And there used to be an Ursa build back in the day where you could max the Earth Shock and just go mana boots. And if you think about it, the nuke, it's a 5-second cooldown nuke that slows for 55%.
Mm.
It's actually ridiculous.
Man, I've seen a bunch of different Ursas. I see a Team Unknown when they were first making their qualifier TI run. And Mr. Kataro Hayama was like safe lane Ursa straight to Midas, and somehow, some way, he just made it work. It was probably one of the manliest Ursas I've seen, but just one of those crowd pleasing heroes that I'm just always happy to see get some game time, you know? Some people, I feel like they see it and they're like, I feel like it'd be great here, but it's an Ursa, and I don't know. If it doesn't go well, people are not going to be happy. Bottom lane, minor tussle here, just an easy poison touch harassment on the Seema, and you know, more creeps that Vega are just going to kind of squabble for themselves.
Yep, looks like they want to contest the pull further, and wow! Wow.
Okay, double kill in mid lane. It looked like an engagement, they traded each other and just died right under the tower. But the one getting the benefit from it, we getting the first kill technically, and we'll get the XP bonus.
That is not what I expected. Even with the Lina nerfs, I don't think Shadow Fiend beats Lina or kills Lina, but nevertheless, the kill is even, in the sense that it went back and forth, and both heroes are relatively close to 6. As you said, we got the advantage with the kill first, so he'll be hitting 6 quicker, but his 6 is not as impactful as a Lina 6, and he'll still have to watch out for the Lina solo kill potential with the Laguna Blade.
There's making things harder for me. I shouldn't have to, you know, situations like that shouldn't really happen, and I'm busy down here with this crazy aggro setup making sure I'm going to be catching all the action breaking down there. But the quietest lane of all is this top lane here. We got Misery going against Doom. It's offlaner versus offlaner right now. And, well, Doom 20-0. Misery, highest CS in the game at the moment. Look at this, near 30-6 on his clockwork, man. He's level 6.5. It's 5 minutes now.
Well, he's got double the amount of mangles that Mag has, so you can only expect this result.
Absolutely. Oh, bottom lane, Pi's in trouble. What? Oh, nice two-man stun. Pi gets the grave, he gets the heal, but the stomp comes through. Pasha's going to clean up one, and they also are going to be able to take down Pilai Dai. Look who's sleeping in now. Weeha, what a sleep setup from Seema. He avoids the raise and gets the hell out of there. What the hell's happening in top lane? Mag makes the move onto Misery. Just after we praise him, he gets caught up with a Doom, and now Doom is trapped. He has no TP. Phase out of there. Oh, he wants the creeps. But now he's too late. Rubik's here. Oh, Rubik can't do anything about it. But what the hell's happening bottom lane? Weeha gets the kill and gets some revenge on the Seema, but quickly no one shows up and finishes off Wee. 8-3 now for Vega.
Action jam-packed indeed, but boy, did you see that nightmare.
Oh, I certainly did. He just saw trouble coming, and he's like, I gotta put myself to sleep.
Yeah. And immediately moved it out of himself and walked away with his extra movement speed. Really, really nice play by Vega, that whole sequence. And of course, dropping that jungle ward, not a traditional location, probably just dropped it because they wanted more vision for the fight. It is nighttime, but I think it dodges the sentry. I'm not sure. The interaction is always weird when you see the line of it, when you the ward itself. Even though it seems like it's on it, sometimes the players don't see it. We're about to find out as Puppy crosses it due time.
Back at top lane here, we still now have a lone Pylai die. I know Misery's somewhere. He's like, I got a hook shot, I'm ready to use it. But he's waiting a long time mid lane for no one to show up. So that actually kind of goes both ways. No one's actually there, but here solo comes, I guess.
No one in solo, yeah.
Just the and solo, they just really no are one. Not making this easy for me at all. Oh, Misery though, I thought he was gonna get a brief sight of Bane right there, but he's going in. He's real hungry. He's just like, I gotta put this hook to use. And I guess he'll head off bottom where there's no one there either. So
yep.
He'll still be running around a bit. And the nice thing is solo gets some solo time. He'll farm up and get close to his level 6 and get that ice blast in line. And Pasha said, I'm done with the boxing gloves a bit. I don't need to get too hot and heavy here. I gotta spend a little bit of me time. And he's doing that in the top lane as we speak.
And quality time he sure will find by himself. In the meantime, the surprising thing for me is that Weeyah is actually at the top of the net worth board, even with 2 deaths. You could say it's the part of the SF, but it's also attributed to his play for sure. Now, one thing that somewhat surprises me as well is that he opted for Presence of the Dark Lord at level 8 over Necromastery 4.
Oh, hold on, Misery used his hook to mid lane! He's dead now, but he used his hook mid lane, got some creeps, and unfortunately Vega were there and they swarmed him. And
well, yep, but he did use his hook.
He used the hook, though. He'd been waiting quite a while, and so have we for it. And next time, I guess he'll think twice before he gets too itchy at the opportunity to make a possible opportunity happen. And
That's the thing with Clockworks, really. I actually have to mention Bulba. He's the one who really started doing this back in the Sniper era. The team that he was on was like the only team that let Sniper through, and they would just pick Clockwork for him every game. And every game at 6, he would just port in mid and wait. And wait and wait and wait, because you know the sniper's not going to farm woods. He's going to be a lane-centric hero. He's going to want to try to pressure the enemy mid laner. They just camp and eventually they'll get the kill. But it's different now. People are camping mids more, they're more wary, and Clockwork's definitely lost that grace. That ability to just take over the game alone. I think that was a classic demonstration of that as well.
Well, now look where he's stuck at. He's back in lane with Pasha. He's like, this isn't really a man mode matchup I want to get into. So he's like, I'll just wait for the creeps to come and I'll just take what little driblets I can and hope Pasha doesn't somehow jump my ass.
how often do you see a Clockwork that says, hey, I'm level 7, but I can't run into them?
But I can't 1v1. Do anything about it. Yeah. Oh, I mean, Vega just kind of dictating the game very well at the start, it feels like here. Mag is level 8, man. I looked at him. He's getting pretty damn gross. Steam is going to get some quality time with him, push forward, you know, closer to get his ultimate here. And I know you're praising a bit Weeyah, and he still holds highest net worth, and can't help but also give a bit of credit to the supports. I'm sure he farmed through some serious stacks to get that boost. I mean, if not, then I guess I'd be that much more impressed after 2 deaths without stacks being that big.
Yeah, still doing a really good job. And just before, you did mention that solo was about to crack level 6, and it's really nice for him too if he gets it by 10 or around 10. Able to apply that much more global pressure. And speaking of which, Mag's going in deep, but I think Pi will be able to get out.
He's gone.
However,
oh, not so lucky. Boom. And the Puppy, he's gonna grave, he's gonna poison touch, and he's gonna say his blessings. He's gone. Smackdown. Mag gets that last tick of damage, and now Vega can segue this into a tier 1 takedown, looks like. And getting a bit nervous here for Secret. I mean, what kind of outs do they have in this game? In last game, you know, once Vega started really pulling ahead, the outs felt very, very minimal for Secret at that point with an Ursa. Do you think there's better chances for him this time now that they're going to be on the back of a Sven? Which we haven't really talked about much as of recent. All he has in his hands is, you know, power treads for now. He still has work to do.
Yeah. Normally, I would definitely agree with the Sven thing. In most Sven games, if you do lose the early game or have a difficult time in the early game, Sven's just that hero that if you can get the farm, eventually you'll get that one engagement where you like 2-3 click the entire enemy team. obviously it's really hard to rely on in a competitive setting, especially against a good team like Vega. And I think it's more on the SF this game. The SF and the Dazzle. It's gonna come down to a scenario where Vega dish out a lot of ultimates or commit a lot of tools to take down the SF. And Secret are just able to turn the fight with the Dazzle, Clockwork follow-up, as well as Sven coming in with a nice stun. And the Warcry buff on the SF is no joke either. And I think that's how to approach it.
Well, the meanwhile, obviously Pasha's gonna find his window of opportunity to head into the Roche. There's no threat there, as Secret took the time to push down the top tier one instead and find some farm for themselves. It's probably something they knew was going on, but knew they couldn't do much about, so they just kind of had to let it happen there. So now we see a very scary Ursa Bear with an Aegis in hand, and he is probably going for Blink Dagger, and he's almost got it. He's got it. Okay, never mind.
I think he has gonna Shadow Blade. Yeah. Okay, there it is. I figured this was the item he wanted to go for, actually. As you said, with the Ursa getting the Blink Dagger, he needs to be able to combat not just the Ursa, but the lane push and map presence in general. Because obviously, his Clockwork and Sven aren't going to be doing it. These heroes can't show themselves in the lane too much, except if you're Eternal Envy, play a lot more aggressive in general. And as you can see at top, he's pushing out the lane deep. But
he's moving in. Oh, it's a swing and a mix for Misery. We are still not going to find the opportunity. Now he finds it. Oh, it's magged down. He's like, I don't even need to use the ulti. I'm going to stand up. And
oh my god.
The cost of his own life. Laguna flies out there from no one. They're going to get the return kill there on the Weeha. Now Pasha committing on in. Asleep for a setup on the Misery. Ice Blast will fly through. And that will lead to a two-man takedown, a two-for-one trade. And Pasha does not even need to use his Aegis as of yet. The rest of Secret kind of scrambling around a bit. I don't know what Envy's doing. I hope he's catching up some from behind, or no, he's just going to opt to go for the woods instead. Promising things continue here for Vega.
Yeah. Nice. I guess it was an okay introduction of the Shadow Blade. Unfortunately for him, he did die, and that obviously hurts, but getting that Doom kill was quite good, I would say. It's going to hinder Mag's progression. Of course, he's the crux of this team, the Shadow Fiend. Weeha really can't afford too many of those kind of deaths, especially after he introduces the Shadow Blade now. Vega are going to be extremely aware, and they're going to start putting down sentry all over the map. And as we see, Seema already has two in his inventory.
Yeah. Not going to be the easiest there. And with Vega coming out in a big fight, that's them not having the Doom in their arsenal. Then it's just a promising thing to come. Oh, Vlad's now almost in order here for Pasha. So we'll get that in work. Misery, you know, fortunately, it's not been his best day so far, so hopefully he'll be able to shake it off. You know, also things could have been very different. He was able to land that hookshot, be in there, and could have prevented Lina or any of them from being able to get in and finish off Weeha after he made the jump on the mag, but those opportunities are just not there, and they need to be in the future for Secret, so we'll see if he's going to be able to kind of pick up the pieces from that point, and it looks like he's going to be building into the mech for his team, given that Weeha obviously needed to go down the road of picking up a Shadow Blade.
So, my guess is that Secret are not going to contest the top tower push too much. Vega's already well in position and they still have the Aegis to go against. So, probably a Fade Bolt after those spell steal, potentially. Just to alleviate the push a little bit and have some more presence. I want to mention this Sven build that's coming out. It's been getting some air. It's been getting some momentum. Mm-hmm. And the thing with Helm of Dominator Sven is that while it adds on to the tankiness, it doesn't really complement Sven's playstyle as a hero. And in my personal opinion, Sven is by design, a very high-risk, high-reward hero. And yeah, even though you can't build a Mask of Madness every game, you really need to look into the option of just playing him that way, maintaining that style. Like compromising the heroes, such as like Ember Spirit, for example, and building like super ridiculous amounts of survivability items, it really like negates the potential of what you can do with the hero as the game progresses. And I think Dominator is one of those things. Like, I think he does like Dominator S and Y. I think it's really weak. I don't think Sven's one of those heroes by design that you can make him like a jack of all trades.
Do you think when you say that, is it because he's, and what makes him so high risk is typically you're banking on a big setup where you just jump in and you just blast, like,
yeah,
like hopefully five shots, their team is not waking up.
Yeah, he's a very timing-based hero, and especially against heroes like Doom, if you get Doomed as a Sven, you're done. Like, it does not matter what items you build.
See the man matchup right now. They make the jump on the Envy, and he is just torn apart, gets the stud off, but the rest of the team is quickly there to swarm up behind him, and now Vega pulling ahead 13-4 and continue what looked like a pretty damn dominant series against Team Secret at this point, who are stuck now frantically, pushing out the side lanes to make up for it.
See, I like that instance is a little biased for what I was saying, and I don't think it's like a fair assessment of the situation. But basically, if he had like a mask or a blink or something like that, he'd be clearing those creeps and he'd be out of there. This hero does not want to ever stay an extended period of time on any situation, at any place on the map, and I don't know, I just don't think the items that people are trying to opt for these days, to try and compromise these things, it's enough.
You hear the noise?
Oh, I heard it, yeah, yeah.
Did you hear it?
Yeah, I heard it.
That is weird. Oh, I missed a kill because of it, dude.
Oh, my bad. We got Weehaw, but
I was... stuff right there, Connell.
I'm sorry, it was just like, I was getting ready to go in the next thought, like, oh, this Aegis has got to be expiring, and then I'm like, oh, we get to hear that sound.
Well, we reaffirmed your sanity, you're not crazy.
Yeah, well, yeah. Unfortunately, I'm crazy bad at the camera, and I missed the opportunity to get Wee. Bottom lane, who does end up going down.
He didn't even Sage. He got used up, and he tried to Shadowblade away, but he was still in tower range. I'm wondering, why did he do that? Maybe he didn't spot the TP coming out of the trees there. I think you can see that one, but I'm not sure, depending on the position of where he was standing. Regardless, he does go down to the Lina. It was a very simple combo kill.
What's here in store for Pasha here? He's got a nice little cute Ogre Club picked up, so BKB seems to be possibly in order for him. And we're attention back to this bottom lane here for Vega. Mag nearby with Doom at the ready. Weehaw, who already Shadowbladed in, was hoping for an easier kill, but they do realize there are a couple of Vega members here, and this kill is suddenly not so easy. Weehaw is not going to be able to get anything off. This time, Misery will connect on the hookshot. Can they burst him down quick? Yeah, he's got the sleep, and quickly, Pasha goes in right for Wee. They're going to annihilate Misery, and Wee's going to be next to go down here. They already have the Doom onto him. He holds on with the Grave and tries to get off as much damage as possible, and, well... they're only able to get down the Bane. And with that left, Puppy shred apart as well. Four going down from the side of Secret, only because Envy is still split pushing up here at the top lane. He'll get that tower down. But Vega, big winners here, Claire.
Yeah, and then Doom actually canceled the TP, so Envy realizes he's free to farm for a little bit longer. Steal the enemy woods, and of course he has
5 TPs in his inventory.
Oh my.
That's the most I've actually seen, without trolling, of course. He definitely panic-bought it.
Yeah, it's I don't know if it's a testament to where they mentally are in this game psychologically, but
it could be seen that way.
But it's probably like earlier when he was about to die, he probably just spam clicked the sticky or quick buy best he can. 5 TP though. I think that's probably
a first for him.
First for everything.
Game's getting a bit mental, it feels, but we'll see who's staying composed now. Vega in a good spot. Look at this.
Oh, sweep dear. It he's in. Gonna get Envy. Run down.
Envy might need to use one of those TPs. Hurry. Oh. Can't get close enough for the Yules. Now he could. He's got the Yules. Ice Blast actually hits him, and he does not want to get hit with a Storm Bolt setup or something. He'll step back and away. Mystery close enough for a hook? No, he was not. So. No engagement will be had, Envy will be able to get away.
I wonder if he got fogged for a moment by the shades of the trees or something, because he auto-attacked instead of Yulesing. And I know the Yules range is shorter now, but he definitely could have caught up in time with his bonus movement speed. So, regardless, it took a little bit longer than expected, and now they're going to go for a different target.
Pie.
Yeah.
Pie gets baked, and... that's enough of that. I mean, that might have been just one of those pie things, you know, he... drew a lot of attention to the top lane, and he allowed time for Weehaw to kind of make some moves here in the bottom, pushes it up a bit, finds no opportunity to get a kill though, and he'll go right back into the grindstone of farming. And, you know, is the weight becoming even more on Weehaw's shoulders at this point? Because Envy, we're still looking at a Sven who's barely at 7,500 net worth right now. It's a struggle as he tries to complete out his BKB. Or do you think the BKB will be enough to, you know, really help out Secret here and maybe having a fight?
Again, there's so many tools on the side of Vega that can deal with the BKB's event. You have Doom, Ancient Apparition Blast, Bane, Fiend's Grip, Ursa that can just ignore a lot of the damage coming with the Enrage. I don't know. I just don't know if it's enough per se. I know he needs it for a fact, no questions about it. But even with the BKB's, what I'm wondering whether he will have that impact. And you know what? He's actually going for that SNY, as I mentioned earlier, with that build with the Dominator SNY.
Oh, you're
man,
right.
I really don't like this build.
Oh, man. I don't know. I mean, I guess there's like, why go a BKB? They got a Doom. They got a Fiend's Grip.
I just don't see why like why you would pick a Sven if you're gonna do this build. It just feels like a Juggernaut would have been a better option most of the time. It does give him the stats again, but it's just so deceptive because Sven needs to do like he needs to do other things most of the time. It just doesn't let him do what he wants to do most of the time. But that's the end of that for the build, I think. I've already touched upon enough, and maybe it'll work. I mean, we know now with the BKB, it's probably not going to be enough against all those BKB piercing ultimates. Especially now, Lina has the Laguna that's with the Agonist Scepter. That'll bypass that too.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, this very well could be the new build. Who knows? We'll see if it's going to be something to blossom into something special or not as Envy heads himself all the way back to the bottom lane where there's a solo waiting for him here. Just trying to find some farm time. Gets his 11 now. So he's got level 2 Ice Blast at the ready. A big and crucial tool. Which is very nice, even against the Sven, to prevent him from getting all that sweet life leech here.
Oh, that's the map
spotted.
Pack.
What the hell? And oh no! Boom! They got him! Laguna, he's done for. He's like, that catapult. What the hell?
Have a map pack vision, and then the catapult's AoE of like aggro is bigger because it has longer range. That's what happened.
Oh, that is.
That's sad. It's very
sad. Unfortunate.
So again, Sven goes down, and that's honestly the fashion I see him drop. You know, with the BKB, even though you have all these ultimates that pierce it, it's like it needs it because he can't get this. At this point, it's kind of like a regardless, no matter what type thing, so it doesn't matter too much. But generally speaking, this like heroes like SF and Sven, just by the nature of how they play Dota, like in your face and they want to get in attack range with you and stuff, they usually want.
We'll check on the other side though for cores on Vega. It's Pasha still building up. He's completed his BKB and still has a fresh Aegis here. I don't know how much time's left on it. I want to say about 2 minutes maybe, but I don't know. I don't see them putting it to use quite yet, but it looks like, as I said, that they are able to purchase up the smoke, and I think Vega are going to go on the move.
Puppy's dead.
I mean, he can't be out here this far and not expect something like this to happen. He rolls in, and Doom shows up, and Puppy is going to try to juke and jab a bit, but he is certainly going down.
There goes the Puppy.
I mean, do Vega need to wait for much more before they decide to, you know, pull the trigger here and take advantage while they have an advantage?
I don't think so. I think they just take the tier 2 top now with the momentum they have from killing. And then they'll have 2 lanes pushed in between mid and top. Of course, bottom lane's a little bit pushed out, but it's Ancient Apparition. He has presence and he has level 2 blast coming in from a very far range, which means it's more likely to hit many more targets. That's probably their goal. Probably their timing. I think they're going to try to hit the high ground here and depending on how Secret hold or how they kill the creep wave, they might back.
Here comes Solo. He's the one that's not with the team, so he's like the quarterback, way back, trying to go for the Hail Mary of a shot. No Secret member, though, is looking to defend that tower, so he didn't have anyone on target. And we'll head back the other way, but we'll see if Vega are going to pursue and going for high ground here or not.
Oh, I thought they should have. I think what Envy did is He misdirected their attention to the bottom lane where he showed himself. Teams usually react to that in two ways. They can either chase the guy that's pushing out the lane, Sven in this scenario, or they can just push saying Sven's not there yet, we can do some damage or force him back. So I think with the advantage that they have, they should have definitely forced him back.
More aggressive of the two. Viz Mag is right on top of Misery here.
Oh, the sentry. Oh my goodness.
His toe like almost tickled the AoE there of that sentry.
Yeah,
but he didn't go all the way.
Wow. I don't know if that was an awareness thing or like. It must have been because they saw him pick up the invis rune at top with that ward there. But Vega's at bottom now. They're pushing to the base.
Yeah. I'm coming in. Mag was looking for anyone to cross on over, but no one's there yet. Now already way into the high ground. Look at this. No one way deep getting pulled back even deeper. Now hit with the stun. He does not have the Aegis, mind you. But the guy who does jumps right on in, and they're going to quickly take out Envy. Laguna and an Ice Blast is all it really takes. And with that, a follow-up on the Pylite Eye will allow Vega now to go into this Tier 3. Secret need to hold here. All the meanwhile, Weehawk pushing the mid lane. Look at this. He's already in the high ground doing damage on the tier 3, but is it going to be a worthy trade? I don't think so. Vega already took down the melee racks, and they're going to start heading back. Weehawk is going to start heading out, and he only gets about a two-thirds of damage done on this tier 3 right now.
Yeah, and he really, really wants to kill Meg here, but Meg's not going to give him the time of day. The creeps are too close to the tower, so he can't walk in proximity, otherwise he'll heal himself. In which case, when he does, between the Shivas and the Doom, there's probably no escape. I think he just chose like the lesser of the two poisons in that scenario and just went for it. I don't think he could have defended the base either, because Doom is still available. Lina ulti wasn't necessarily off cooldown yet, but AA Blast was coming up, and Ursa still had the Aegis as well as the BKB, so fighting into that is definitely asking for a death sentence. Speaking of death sentences, Puffy!
Yeah, Puffy, this is like... That's the wrong neighborhood, man, yeah. I'm sorry. He's just walking
right
through
town,
like a casual civilian, just like minding his business, and he is gone. So it's just Puffy Dazzle, after all, one of the lower net worths. It doesn't hand over too much, and he has a relatively low death timer if the push is to come. But obviously, I guess just Secret need to take that bit of intel and know that they need to stay on high alert. Pi already taking some measures here. We'll try to sentry down and get some vision back, but there's nothing for you there, my friend. And I don't think we mentioned it yet, but Pasha, with a DD in hand right now, has a Basher also recently picked up, and he might be able to put it to use on Weehaw. Ho ha ho ha ho! He's gone. That was vicious.
Yeah. A pretty nice chain like combo right there. A real good combo attacker. Nice bash. Was that the first hit bash or a second hit bash?
I don't know. I was too busy making random noises.
The SFX, the sound effects, man. Complimentary indeed.
You could just feel the violence coming, and I guess it just takes over you at times, but mm-hmm. He just makes a huge dent right there in the Secret, taking Weehaw down, and they're like, hey, maybe we can force him to buy out now. How much better would that be? So they're just going to push themselves down this mid lane and see if they can force one. I don't think they can, though. They got about 20 seconds left. Envy can throw out a stun. Puppy can throw out one of those. It looks like they'll be able to stall out, but do they stick around? Well, let's see what Vega decide to do.
They certainly don't have to. Roshan's spawning time begins in 1 minute, but this is Vega. They're feeling pretty confident now. Looks like they're going in.
Pasha certainly wants to. He's inching out front. Does not pop his BKB for the stun and could be in trouble here. Pops his R button and he just slays Misery. And for the rest of, Vega, they continue to tirade on forward here. Pasha barely kept it alive, but will be taken down at the end of the Fade Bolt. And for the rest of Secret, they retreat back. Puppy's going to be forced to grave himself. Pilot Eye making some trades here with no one, but no one hits a lot harder. And the level death coming in from Mag secures his mega kill streak. And a strong fight for Vega as they will be able to clear out the tier 3. Rax in jeopardy. Ceres in jeopardy now. Weehaw makes his return, a buyback from Envy, a buyback from Pylite Eye. Vega tried to quickly 180 and get the hell out of there, but they can't quite make it away solo. Tried to hide under the Glimmer Cape, but they have the sentry and they will take him down. Mag, one of the few survivors. Also, of course, no one was able to make it away. But hey, Vega now, two lanes where they have two different racks.
Yeah, and Vega are very happy with that result there. They did lose an extra Ancient Apparition towards the end, and unfortunately for him, they gave up the gem in the process as well, but that was the buyback out of the Sven as well as the Rubik. And I think the SF already... No, he did not buy back actually, so that was kind of nice on Secret. But it just goes to prove to their worth that Sven's going to be hindered that much more. Again, they're very content with the result, and I imagine the next Roshan will be in their favor. They do have the Ursa, and they do have total control for the time being when it comes to map, when all their heroes are up. And Envy needs to be careful, and I think
yes,
he recognizes
that. Yes, he certainly does. We saw that it only took a simple Laguna Ice Blast to finish him off, so
yeah.
Sit back, buddy. All right, he will relax for now, and they trade on the other side. No one goes in the same time Pi does. Gets the lift back. Misery jumps in, but they have just jumped into a bad fight with a big mean bear, and he is just slashing them apart. Oh, don't look. No one is now godlike. Four members of Secret are down, and Puppy has said, we are done here. He has thrown in the towel. Vega have just 2-0'd Secret. Congratulations again to Mag, his 1,001 game. Is another victory for him.
Wow.
What a performance, Claire.
You know, they seem like somewhat landslide victories towards the end, both games, and not a result I expected out of the Secret versus Vega series, but